Welcome dear all in our YouTube channel Alexis Project and myself Professor Mohin Sheikh, and here is a new setup project you can see available on your screen. Okay, title name is IoT based water quality monitoring system. So hardware model is as available on your screen. So let's see each and every component. So one by one, here is a main switch and it is used to turn on and off the entire system. Okay, in this way. Next component is an input jack. Okay, here we can connect a DC adapter here to provide power supply to all the system as it is system required. Next sensor is a turbidity sensor, and it is used to, you can see here is a turbidity sensor head. Okay, and here is the processing unit, and we can also remove it in this way. Okay, and can connect it. It is removable for study purpose and maintenance purpose. Next component is a temperature sensor, and it is used to measure the water temperature. It is a waterproof temperature sensor. Next component is ESP32 board we are using as a brain of the system, and it is removable as you can see. So let's remove it. Okay, so you can see. Okay, and it is responsible to handle entire operation like sending data to IoT server, running LCD, taking the sensor data, converting it. All is responsible this microcontroller board. Next component is LCD screen here, and it is an essential part of our project as we need to display the parameters. If suppose internet is not available, so we can also see the parameters live offline on this LCD screen. So let's attach it again. Next component is a pH sensor processing unit, you can see here. Okay, it is used to measure the parameters coming from pH sensor, so it is also removable as you can see. Okay, component is a pH sensor here. Okay, it is a sensing knob. Okay, so you can see here we are converting the analog data to digital data using this wire and this processing unit, and this wire is a TDS converter. Okay, as you can see, we are using one TDS sensor here. Okay, so it's a quantity is coming into this controller board or processing board. Okay, see, very important. You can write your guide name here using the pen. Okay, using the pen and a handle, you can write your guide name here, and here is our project name. Okay, and here students can write their names, project group names here. Okay, for there is to write start. So, and here we will use we will turn on the adapter. Okay, and now we will turn on the projector. So you can see name is appearing, water quality water-based water quality monitoring system. Okay, and then after doing all the arrangements, now we will connect our project to the personal hotspot. For this, we will use this cell phone. Okay, and we will visit to the personal hotspot settings. So you can see it is here. Okay, every phone has different kind of settings, and we will click on this, and we will edit the settings. Okay, all the projects have different settings. Remember, and it is I'm putting here for the example only. Okay, after writing the personal hotspot name and settings. Okay, remember, we will provide it after buy the setups. We will provide all the settings, and you will need to put it in the hotspot settings, and we can save it. Okay, remember, and after 4 to 5 seconds, your project will automatically connect here, and it will show your connection management devices. Okay, after doing all that, it's time to visit IoT server. For this, we can use any kind of web browser. So we will use Chrome browser here. Okay, and entering the browser, and we can search here Adafruit.io. Okay, you can see, and we can click in, and after this page, we can click on this link, first link. Okay, and when you will reach here, you need to log in using the ID and password provided by us. Okay, and you can visit to the dashboard, and then you can click on the project name in the dashboard, and you can see all the parameters here. Okay, in this way. Okay, student, our project is currently on. Okay, and here's our setup is also connected to the IoT server, so you can see all the readings. Okay, and remember, in this session we will test the turbidity sensor here. Okay, for that we have four cup here. Okay, with pure water. Okay, and here we have some amount of powder. Okay, so we will disturb the water turbidity, or you can see water purity, by adding this powder to the water. Okay, and we will test its ability readings. Okay, so let's add some little bit amount. We will keep it pure water, okay, to test the ability, and we will add some amount. Okay, we will adding very little amount of powder to this cup. Okay, and we will stir it, and then we will take now double quantity than previous one. So you can see it is double than previous one. We will dip it inside this one. Okay, and we will stir it. Okay, remember we are just taking now turbidity sensor test. Okay, we are trying to make the water dirty. Okay, and mixing it a lot of particles to it, and then we will take the turbidity reading. And now this time we will take the double amount than previous one. So we will take this amount. Okay, actually it is a powder so dense, so we will add it in this way. Okay, you can see water the density has increased, and there are a lot of particles. Okay, so removing this spoon, and you can see this is pure water, so it will give maximum turbidity reading. And then after. So okay, let's put this sensor in here in this cup. Okay, and now we will test the turbidity reading. So actually this is a rough reading. Okay, so don't consider it. New reading is coming now. So see, now new reading has came. You can see new readings are 90%. It is showing that this water is pure and no particles. 90% is pure. Okay, only it's showing around 10% it is impure. Okay, means this water is so pure. So you can see here turbidity is around 90%. You can see, and here is the graph. Okay, you can see graph showing 90%. Now we will change the water quality from this to this. We will put the sensor. Okay, this way. Okay, so water is fixed. And you can see new readings are 85%. Okay, because water purity has decreased. Little bit amount of powder is mixed. That's why it is showing now around 80% of purity. So you can see here. Okay, you can see turbidity is around 79. Okay, see turbidity pop quality has decreased from here to here. Okay, now again we will put the sensor to this water. Okay, and we will take new readings. So what is the new reading? We will check. See, new readings are 64% of turbidity. See, okay, sample 3 has 64% of turbidity. So you can see it is from 79 to 82, technically reducing from 64. Okay, quality is decreasing, you can see in the graph. Okay, and you can see on this gauge. Okay, now we will put the sensor to the last one, and this one we will steal a little bit. Okay, and now 6. Okay, waiting for new readings. See, quality has decreased. Okay, 44% of turbidity. You can again see on the graph. Okay, current readings is 65%. Sorry, it is taking some time for reducing it. So you can see the new readings are 44% of quality. You can see quality is decreasing in the graph. Okay, because we are changing the samples. Okay, so it means turbidity sensor is working so fine. So after testing the turbidity sensor, now we will test the TDS sensor. So here you can see we are again same samples. Okay, all the samples here, all 4. Okay, and we will add some amount of salt to all this water. As you know, you can understand TDS sensor work on the water conductivity, and to increase the water conductivity we need to add the salt to the water samples. So let's add a little bit. So you can see we will add this amount of salt to the sample. Okay, sample number 2, and then again we will increase the salt quantity. You can see it is doubled than previous one. So we will add to the third sample, and then remaining last we will add greater quantity than our previous one to the last sample. Okay, in this way water conductivity will increase, and we can test the different TDS value of the water. Now you can see this is purely neutral water. Okay, so its reading is TDS value is 333 BPM. Okay, you can see here, and also live on the server, IoT server. You can see, good. This is the current TDS value, and here is the graph. Okay, currently it is showing 31333 value. Okay, for TDS. So this sample has 333 ppm TDS value. Okay, so let's change the sample from this to this. And as you know, now turbidity should increase. So you can see new readings has arrived. You can see new readings are 434 ppm here. Okay, and also live you can see on the reading 433 ppm. You can see graph is increasing from year to year. Okay, old reading was 33, now it is around 433. Okay, let's change the sample from this to this, and again you know TDS value should increase as this. Okay, so you can see new readings are 738 okay ppm of this sample's reading is, and also we can see live on server here on IoT server. You can see the new graph is increasing from year to year. Okay, estimates our system is working fine. Let's put this on the highest value of salt sample. So in this way we can put the sensor and waiting for the new readings. Okay, a reading should increase as that sample has more amount of salt, so waiting for the new reading. Okay, live you can see here, after some moment we will see new reading here. Cool, keep an eye on here, see. Okay, now ppm is higher. Okay, as you can see more than 1000, it means it has highest amount of salt. You can see readings has increased, you can see in the graph. Okay, it means our TDS sensor is working so fine. So let's put that sensor again to the neutral water. Okay, so after testing the TDS sensor, now we will test the temperature sensor. For this we will use this this bottle has chilled water. Okay, super chilled water, and we will add the water quantity in ascending order in this way. So here's the water, we will pour it in this pot, and then we will add three decans of water to this sample. Okay, so in this way we can see. Okay, sorry, we will add to this one, two, three. Okay, and now we will add two water to this one, two cups, one and okay two, and we will add one to this. Okay, to reduce the water temperature. Okay, so this neutral water has temperature around 29.4 degrees. Okay, also we can see on live server here. Okay, here you can see. Okay, water temperature 29.4 degrees, and here's the graph. So let's see the water temperature of this sample. Okay, so let's put it here, and we will check the temperature. It will take a little bit delay to take the new readings. So wait for it. Okay, so new readings are coming. Okay, you can see its reading is 21.9 degrees C. You can see. Okay, and your current reading is 27.9 degrees C. And let's put the change the sensor from this to this, and now again temperature we should increase a little bit. Okay, so here you can see this sample has a reading of 26.7 degrees C. Okay, you can see here 26.8 degrees C, and let's change the sample from this to this. Okay, and now waiting for the new readings. So you can see reading is again increasing because this has a low amount of chilled water. Okay, so reading is 27.3 degrees C. You can see a little bit increasing temperature. Okay, you can see. So it means our temperature sensor is also working so fine. Now we will take the last test of pH sensor. After testing other parameters, now it's time to test the pH sensor. Okay, so to measure the pH values, as you know, this water is actually neutral water. Okay, and this has around 7.5 pH value. Okay, which is means it is neutral alkaline, you can consider. Okay, so we will add some amount of acid. This bottle actually has inside acid. Okay, cleaning acid you can consider. So we will add this acid to the water. Okay, and then we will test the pH value of this water. So let's add here, you can see if I added it, some one, and also this one, and also this one. Okay, remember it's an acid, okay? So that our pH sensor can sense some amount of acidity in the model. So let's put this in this sample. Actually, it's a neutral water. Okay, so first we will put it into the neutral water. Okay, so I have placed, and now we are waiting for this is rough reading. Okay, we will look for new reading here on the IoT server. You can see live. Here is the graph. Okay, current value is 6.88 pH. So you can see current value is 6.606. So you can see pH value. Okay, it means this water is nearly around neutral, or you can consider alkaline. Okay. So now let's dip this sensor to this sample. Okay, and now we will test the new reading. Okay, currently it is 6.28 for neutral water, and now we are testing sample number 2. It takes some time for new reading. So you can consider this, you can see actually this sample is acid, that's why it's showing 5.66 pH value. Okay, also you can see live on server. Okay, pH value is getting down. Okay, as acidic condition is increasing. So now let's put this pH sensor to the sample number 3 here, and now we will check what is the pH value. Okay, so waiting for the new readings. See, new readings are, you can see 5.3 here and 5.3. okay, for sample number 3 we can see the graph of pH value, and now we are going to put this sample to this one, and we will check what is the reading of this. Okay, so we are placed and waiting for new readings. Okay, so we will get a lower reading nothing this time. Okay, you can see pH value is 2.99, you can consider. Okay, it means it has a highest acidic level. Okay, this sample has highest acidic level, that's why it is showing 2.99. okay, so our pH sensor is also working so fine. So after testing all the parameters, so this project is working so fine. If any student want to purchase this model, okay, so they can contact us through our video description. Okay, there each and everything is provided, like email address or contact number. Okay, you can WhatsApp and take queries about this model. Okay, you can consider this model for your graduation BE, also for MTech. So thank you so much for watching the video. Take care.